What's up, Rockstar?
There are a lot of people here.
It's a big room. Yeah, New Jersey is the bomb. Yeah, we really appreciate it, man. Look at this, man.
I know, it's wild.
Yeah.
Thanks everyone for coming.
Yeah, we super appreciate it. I mean, like my joke is always, thanks to the fans, I live at the beach. You know, think about ourselves. We have a great life because of you guys, and we really appreciate you. All right, so you get a little time one-on-one with Colin. Enjoy it.
Thank you very much.
All right, let's hear it one more time for Colin.
I sort of don't want to answer any questions, so why don't you just keep screaming, it's great. Okay. Alright then. I've been known to dance. I'm not gonna. I'll end up breaking my other foot on stage. I think I thought I could dance till I broke my foot doing that episode. So I guess I know that's the only reason I bring it up is I like the art. I like to think I can dance, but I think probably a lot of people would say that I can't. Irish Rory Timbers. Thanks very much. Consider my timbers shivered.
Are you talking about me as in me?
Yeah.
Or okay.
Let me answer the question.
I'm gonna say Smee. Because Chris is awesome.
Sea dog, or does his pet
answer
to
Polly
want to crack?
You have a black retriever cross and you call it Buckley. That's what he does. Nice. Yeah. I do, yes. I was there. Is that the question? Yes, I do remember. It was just awkward, and I guess it looked guess we just made it work. It was fun. That's a while ago now.
Yeah.
That was good. Good fun. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Irene, and I wanted to ask, how did you get onto Once Upon a Time?
How did I get onto it? I auditioned for it. That's actually what happened. I think that wasn't a joke. I auditioned for it and met with Ed and Adam. Then they liked what they saw. And then I came on. So I didn't expect to be on for as long as I have been, and I'm very grateful. Say and not say some things that I can't say, so that are have a big impact on who this character is. He is, well, we know, I don't want to spoil it for people, but has everyone seen the movie?
No.
This is from last night, so you know that he's looking for his daughter. And that is a massive difference psychologically than where original Hook was. And he's desperately lonely, I think, because he can't find her. So, who said that? Okay. You can join the group. I think that's the big difference. Thanks.
Hi, my name is Anna,
and I was wondering how you feel about Emma not being on the show anymore. Aww. It's a big change. Obviously, I've worked with Jim for so long, and we get on great, and the character. But I think where the characters went and how they closed that chapter was really, really good, and it's sort of a good way of honouring the amount of effort that those characters put into being together and stuff. And now she's pregnant, and they go off and have their happy ending. So that was great. I mean, it's a big change. You know, this season is a big change, but in my opinion, it's some of the best writing we've had on the show. You know, and some of the best episodes. Definitely, next week's episode is probably the best episode I've read of the show since I started on it. So that's next week. It's not a big Hook episode or anything like that. It's just an amazing episode. So it's a big change, but it's been great. You know, Andy is amazing. You know, all the new cast are fantastic. It's nice to get to work with new people as well. Let's work with, you know, people who had worked with before. So it's good.
Thank you.
Thanks. I'm kind of rambling a little bit, sorry.
Hi, what is your favorite line you said as Hook?
If I jab you with my sword, you'll feel it. You're welcome.
For Hook and Emma, what would the girl name be,
and what would
the boy name be?
I don't know. I don't know because I want. What? Killian Junior and Lee Matt.
Thank you.
My mom. Have I had a boat? I have a boat. Well, I'm the Jolly Roger. But you mean me? Actually, me.
If you have a boat in real life,
I would probably have to call it the Jolly Roger. yeah, probably. Well, what would you call your boat?
Don't sink.
Thanks for that. Hello there.
Hi. Who's your favorite captain? And why?
Who's my favorite captain?
Character.
On the show? Captain Hook. That's a difficult one because I think I like I pretty much like all the characters for different reasons. I do like the craziness of Rumpel when he's Rumpel Stiletto. He's pretty incredible, Bobby. So
thank you
very much.
Hi, Colin. I'm Rachel.
Hi.
How are you? I was wondering, in your career, have you ever been starstruck, and if so, with whom?
I got starstruck the first time I met Anthony Hopkins.
You were wonderful in that movie, by the way.
Well, thank you very much. Maybe a little bit starstruck when I met Gabriel Byrne, because he was such a huge part of, like, you know, Irish film and stuff. I've met some other people that I haven't worked with that I've never started with, but probably I would say Anthony Hopkins, but it was really sweet because I do a, what they call a chemistry read to get the cards, and basically I think it was if he didn't like me, I wouldn't have got the role, and I was super nervous and I arrived in early, and there was a room in a hotel kind of like this more, and I was there early, and I was like, oh god, I have to give myself 10 seconds to freak out, so then he came in, and I could feel myself beginning to go, like, tremble, you know what I mean? And he just came up and gave me a hug, and he said, hello Colin, it's nice to meet you, let's just have fun. I was like, okay.
Thank you.
Hold on a second, what is going on?
I'm happy!
Well, you guys haven't been doing it after everything I said. I just said something else then, you didn't say it. So anyway. Alright, this is going to get old quick. I see you, Michael Coleman, skulking around. I haven't noticed it.
My name is Jacob, and you are my favorite character right next to Ron Paul. So my question is...
I got your favorite character if I'm standing next to Ron Paul.
Well, first off, my least favorite episode was Firebird, because I really thought you were going to be gone for good. Were you scared that you were actually going to be kicked out of the cast then?
Is Firebird the one where I die?
Firebird is where Hades tricks you into thinking there's a way to bring you back, but there isn't, and Emma ends up going up the elevator without you. Yeah, you're really scared that you were going to be leaving.
I didn't read it. I had already died a couple of times on the show. The guys are kind of good at when they kill me in the show, they sort of say, don't worry, you're not gone for good. And I go, okay. So when they kill me and they don't say that to me, that's when I'll know that I'm dead. But they did say to me after that, so don't worry, you're not gonna kill you off. Okay? So I did think though at times, I was like, after that, I wanted them to leave a couple of episodes where I wasn't in it so that people would think that I was gone. And I kind of
Why?
because as a viewer, the payoff when the character comes back is way more than for in my that's just my opinion. When I watch something, if I think they're dead and gone, it's like, oh no. And then in an episode or two when they come back, it's like, oh my god, I didn't see that happen. So that's sort of it, but yeah, no, I didn't think that was gone.
Thank you. Hi, folks. You see, I'm known for name taking arts. Do you have a name for yours? And you have a favorite?
I don't actually have names for them. My favorite might be. I'm boring for you, but not my guitarist, so. The 1972 Fender Custom Deluxe Telecaster. That's probably, I bought that when I was 16, so that's probably my favorite. I have an acoustic that I got from a friend of mine as a signature Gibson acoustic, but he got one for me called KMO Signature, and that's one that I wanted for a long time, so I guess that's another one. I did a music video, and for doing the music video, Christine Perry got me a Gibson, which I've wanted for a long time. So I like all the guitars, to be honest. So yeah, I like them all.
Thank you.
Now even you lot are bored of saying it.
I was wondering, what other jobs have you had besides acting?
I gigged in a band for 10 years. I worked in a shoe shop. I worked in a clothes shop. I worked in a sports shop. Worked in lots of shops. That was kind of it. Thank you.
If you always knew that Hoagie
and Emma would be together, because I know when, from when they first met, I had a feeling they would be together forever, so I just wanted to know what you thought. I didn't know it would be forever, but I did know that if they got together, I thought it would be like a kind of a thing, you know what I mean? So when I first started on the show, I thought that Hoagie and Emma could be, I think it was going to be like a love triangle. Similar to like Sawyer and Jack and Kate and Lost. So that was sort of, you know, my character was kind of the Sawyer character of the three, so. But I kept my picture on. That was it, so I kind of knew. You're just not listening to me, is that it? That's okay. I kind of knew.
Hey, I'm Jessica. I was wondering, because you know the show's like about hope and not giving up and all that. So, what do you, like, especially as an actor, what do you do when you feel like you're about to give up hope or like everything seems bad?
I always try to look on the positive side of things, because like as an actor I did nearly give up golf dance, only for my wife sort of got me through, my family, you know, but I was lucky. You don't have to block that. I've been lucky that I had that support. A lot of people don't have that support, so I always try to look on the positive side and know that at some point you get through it, you find your way through, and that's the most important thing. It's not to think about the immediate, think about the future. My self-help book would be out.
I do to her? Oh, yeah, man. That was actually good. Probably that one. But I wrote an autograph, so that's you. So that, probably that one. Also because that's the only one I can remember. So, yeah. She always gets out about me at these things, Karen. She's always having a go at me. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Faith, and I was just wondering, if you get
any tattoo, what would it be and where? What did you say your name was? I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to tell you. Don't you worry about it. Thank you. It's fun.